ابن العباس. He ended up burying all the bodies. He went back towards Kufa and then towards Sham. And when they would ask him later, "O Ali ibn al-Husayn, what was the most difficult part for you? Was it Karbala? Was it Kufa? Was it Sham?" He would reply, "Ash-Sham, Ash-Sham, Ash-Sham." And he would say, "If you saw the way they treated us in Sham." He says, "On the first day we entered Sham, Sahal bin Sa'ad al-Sa'adi, a companion of Rasulullah, came to Ali ibn al-Husayn. When he came to him, he saw him. He says, Sahal says, I saw everybody merrymaking. Everybody was joyous. Everybody was happy. I thought, is this day a day of Eid? So I asked someone, is this a day of Eid? They said, no. Do not be surprised if the heavens turn on us and the earth sucks us. Said, what is it? The reply was, these are the family of the Prophet of God. And they have been killed and these are their prisoners. Sahal bin Sa'ad al-Sa'adi narrates, I saw Ali ibn al-Husayn with chains around his body. I came to him and I said to him, O Ali ibn al-Husayn, I am Sahal bin Sa'ad al-Sa'adi, the companion of your great grandfather Rasulullah. He looked at me and he said, O Sahal, I beg of you one thing. Please go and buy a piece of cloth for me. Sahal thought, if I go and buy a piece of cloth, it means Ali ibn al-Husayn wants the cloth to cover his body. He says, I bought the piece of cloth to Ali ibn al-Husayn and I saw him put the piece of cloth between the chain and his neck. And he said to me, O Sahal, the chain has been cutting through my neck since Karbala. Then after that, Imam Ali ibn Husayn narrates, Wallah, we were walking and a man came to me and said, curse on you and curse on your people. He looked at him and he said, oh man, do you know who we are? The man said, I don't, but I've been told you are a group of rebels, so curse on you. He said to him, oh man, have you read the verse in the Quran? قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَىٰ. He said, yes, I have. He said, have you read the verse in the Quran? وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَ وَلِلرَّسُولِ وَلِذِي الْقُرْبَىٰ. He said, yes, I have. He said, have you read the verse in the Quran? إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. الله. He said to him, yes, I have. He said, do you know who those verses refer to? He said, yes, they refer to Al Muhammad. He said, then who are we? He looked at him, he said, who are you? He said, I am from Al Muhammad. That's my father's head you see on the spear. He said, who? He said, Hussein ibn Ali. He said, they have killed Hussein ibn Ali. He said, yes. Imagine those people did not know who was killed. And that's why in the Bazaar of Sham, you've been to the Bazaar of Sham? In that Bazaar, do you know what the narrations say? The narrations say that when Imam Zain al-Abidin was taken through the Bazaar, what is called Jami' al-Amawi today, that area towards Jami' al-Amawi, Sugh al-Hamidiyah, when Imam Zain al-Abidin was taken, you know what Bibi Zainab says? She says, there were people pouring boiling water on the head of my nephew. And they were poking him with spears as he was walking through the bazaar. And then we arrived at Yazid's palace and Imam Zain al-Abidin had to see Yazid flick the lips of Imam al-Husayn with a stick. But I tell you, Imam Zain al-Abidin, that khutbah he gave in Sham, that khutbah, he was only 22. And it's a message to our 22-year-olds. Have you ever given a lecture like your master Zain al-Abidin? At the age of 22, he stood in front of Yazid and he gave a khutbah which shook Yazid's empire. When he said, Allah has granted us 6 and given us excellence in 7. Allah has given us knowledge and Allah has given us patience, eloquence, generosity, forbearance, and the believer's love for us. And he's given us excellence in 7. From us is Rasulullah. From us is Ali. From us is Hamza. From us is Ja'far. From us is Hassan. From us is Hussein. And from us is the Mahdi. Those of you who know me, know me. Those of you who don't, let me tell you who I am. I am the son of Mecca and Mina. I am the son of Zamzam and Safa. I am the son of the best of man to have held the black stone in his robe, and the best of them to have circumambulated the Kaaba. I am the son of the man who was taken by Buraq through the air. I am the son of the man who led the angels in prayer. I am the son of the man who was taken to Sidrat al-Muntaha. I am the son of Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am the son of Ali al-Murtada, the one who fought the disbelievers until they said La ilaha illallah. I am the son of the man who fought with two swords and with two spears, who went on two migrations. I am the son of the believers, pious one, the descendant of the prophets, the annihilator of the polytheists, the commander of the faithful, the glory of the worshippers. Then he continued to say what? I am the son of the man who fought the disbelievers and exterminated their progenies, the man who was the best of them in prayer, the guardian of Allah's wisdom and his arrow targeting all the hypocrites. I am the son of the master of Iraq, the master of Iraq and the lion of Hijaz. I am the son of a Mekki and a Madani and a Badri and a Khifi and a Aqabi and a Muhajiri and an Ansari. That's my grandfather Ali ibn Abi Talib. Then he says, I am the son of the masters of the youth of paradise, Hassan and Hussein. Then he says, I am the son of Fatima al-Zahra. Until he says, I am the son of the man who was slain on the earth of Karbala. When he said this, Yazid said, recite the adhan, quickly recite the adhan. Do not let him continue. When they recited the adhan, and the person called out, Allahu Akbar, Imam Zain al-Abidin called out in front of the people, truly, there is none as great as Allah. Then when he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, he said, my eyes and my hands and all my body testify that there is no Lord but Allah. Then when he said, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Imam said, O Yazid, is Muhammad your grandfather or is he mine? If you say he's your grandfather, then you are a liar. But if you know he is mine, then why did you kill my father on the plains of Karbala?